Doug Kremer emailed me asking if I wanted to try a 3D printed impeller for a blower. And after a few emails back and forth, he sent me this thing here. He'd also printed the housing for it, but when he realized how much it cost to send stuff to Canada, he decided to keep that one himself. So I designed a volute-shaped housing in SketchUp and printed that one-to-one on multiple sheets of paper with my big print program. And that looks okay, but it doesn't actually need to be quite that big. It helps to have space around the impeller, but I probably don't need that much. So I scaled it down by 10%, and this is the one I'm going with. And making a volute-shaped housing is always a bit of a challenge. I still haven't got a good way of doing it without wasting a lot of material. This time I thought I'd just try some construction lumber, thick pieces that would go in segments around it, like this, which I drew in SketchUp and worked out the dimensions of the various pieces. And then I cut those out on the table saw. And to hold the pieces together while the glue dries, I'm just putting a screw straight through the joint. Got my volute housing done and a servo motor on the back of it. And the nice thing about this motor is I can command it to go any speed I want to from a Raspberry Pi computer here. And that's also hooked up to an anemometer and two pressure sensors. And you can also read power to the motor using one of these smart plugs. And for now, I just got a piece of wood on the motor instead of this impeller because I'm still testing the setup. So I'm slowly stepping up the RPM in steps of 200 RPM and at each speed pausing for a while to stabilize and then taking anemometer and pressure and power readings. RPM, pressure readings which don't vary because I'm not actually sensing the blower. Power consumption goes up quite dramatically and then the wind speed over here. Now measuring flow here is difficult because it's not evenly distributed, so I want to measure it on the input side. And for that I made this box to go on here with the anemometer going in here, so that's hopefully representative of the speed going through the box. And I made this box to hold the other pressure sensor, one of those things, with a tube on the front so I can use it as a pitot tube to kind of try to gauge wind speed as well. And here's my data, and I estimated the inflow and outflow, inflow with the anemometer, outflow with the pitot tube, and they're within 15% of each other, which is actually not too bad in my opinion, because unconstrained airflow is really hard to kind of estimate that way. I kind of assumed the airflow was evenly distributed. And here's the power as a function of RPM. It's kind of a bumpy curve, so I'm not so sure about those smart plug readings. My assumption was that the flow rate was consistent across this whole area. I guess it's not. And for the outlet, I assume that this pitot tube here would represent the flow rate across that whole area. All very approximate. I'm not so sure about those AC readings from my smart plug, so I'm also taking some DC readings at the output of the power supply and I have to record those manually. Purple and blue are my smart plug power readings and yellow is the DC power readings, and they follow fairly closely. And calculating the power supply efficiency, it's actually fairly consistent once we get above 100 watts. And now let's take the paddle off, and then taking a series of readings of how much power that motor takes without any load on it. Blue is my no load power curve, yellow is with the paddle, and plotting the difference between those two, I get this yellow curve, and the black curve is actually just the RPM cubed curve, so it does follow that fairly nicely. Power going up with RPM cubed is what I would expect, and my other data seems to make a lot of sense too, so I have faith in my apparatus and I'm ready to actually test the impeller now. And I accidentally pushed that impeller too far down the shaft. Fortunately, I had the foresight to drill two small holes in the impeller for pulling it back out before putting it on. And now testing with the actual impeller, and once again, I'm manually recording the DC input current. I could get my Raspberry Pi computer measuring that, but I think by the time I get that working to my satisfaction, I don't think I'd be saving any time. And looking at the numbers, the impeller used more power than the paddle did for the same RPM, but it also moved more air than the paddle. So graphing here, air moved versus how much power I needed, the paddle needed more power to move the same amount of air than the impeller did, and the yellow line is just a cubic model, just to show that goes along with that. And so calculating the efficiency gain, for the same amount of air moved, the impeller used about 3/4 as much power as the paddle, except at the final setting, it's about 2/3. So that is a pretty good gain, although if we look at it in terms of how much air we moved, we're only doing maybe 10-12% better. But that makes perfect sense, because in the same blower, to move 10% more air takes about 30% more power if it follows the cube model. So if we hold the flow rate fixed and look at the power, we expect that difference to be a lot bigger than if we hold the power fixed and look at a difference in flow rate. So far my tests have been with backwards facing fins. Now I want to test it with forward facing fins, but I can't just flip this impeller around because then the hole's on the wrong side, but I can reverse the housing. So aside from being much louder and knocking my peanut toot off the table, it also consumed dramatically more power, but it cut out at 2800 RPM and the servo just kind of lost phase, it was overpowered. Now comparing forward facing versus backward facing vanes, the flow rate is considerably higher by about 26%, but if we look at the power consumption as a function of RPM, it's dramatically higher, more than double. But then if we plot the power consumption versus flow rate here, power consumption and vertical, it's actually not that far apart. The backwards facing ones on average use about 17% less power, except for this final one here. But the power for the servo is really taking off here because it's getting close to its limit and probably getting less efficient. So the difference in efficiency is not as big as I imagined it would be. And if you're limited by RPM, because for instance, your motor only has so many RPM, forward-facing fins may actually make more sense, because you're only losing about 17% efficiency, but if you can get more flow and you have the power, forward-facing fins make more sense. Now in real life, a dust collector blower has to suck through a lot of hoses and ducts and a filter or a cyclone, so let's simulate that by making it suck through a smaller hole. And I also ran that for the backward facing ones, and the flow rate is of course much lower. The flow rate difference isn't very large, but if we look at the power usage, that difference is quite substantial. And plotting flow rate versus power usage, this is on the same scale as before, zooming it up a bit, the difference is quite large. I have some weird data point right here, but I thought I'd written down the numbers wrong for the current, but checking my smart plug readings, those kind of confirmed that strange data point, so something funny happening with the servo controller at that speed. But the efficiency gain is quite substantial for the backward-facing fins with the restricted airflow. And I suspect the reason why the difference is bigger for the restricted airflow is that the impeller is just spending a lot of time just churning without that much air flowing through it, and the backwards-facing fins are just so much more aerodynamic in terms of sweeping past the air versus the front-facing ones, that just caused a lot of turbulence. So for restricted airflows, the backward-facing fins are definitely a win. Of course, if you're restricted by RPM, forward-facing is still moves more air, although with more power, but a better solution to that is just make a bigger impeller, providing that you have room for the bigger blower. And looking at blowers with forward-facing fins, this one's from a dehumidifier, this one's a range hood, this one's from a clothes dryer, this one's for a furnace. They all have squirrel cages with forward-facing fins. And these all run at fairly low RPM, and they're for moving lots of air at very low pressure. Compared to these two blowers, which are out of vacuum cleaners, and they have backwards-facing fins, and they run at high RPM and create lots of pressure, small volume.
And this one's not from a vacuum cleaner, but it also generates fairly high pressure. And I partially disassembled it. And you can see it spins this way, and here's one of the rotors, and it has very thin layers of backwards facing fins.
And you see the same design in water pumps that have to generate a lot of pressure.
And something like a dust collector is somewhere in between, because it has a lot of air resistance from the ducting and from the filter. Although with this one, because it sucks the dirt through the blower, straight fins is the only thing that works. Otherwise the dirt will stick to the scoops.
Although for any dust collector blower that I've built, I don't want to suck debris through a wooden impeller, so I have to filter before the impeller, at which point I can just use backwards curving fins because I don't have debris going through it.